Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Respected viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. Hello and welcome to the 21st episode of the Treaties of Rights series with me, your host, Ali Jassim. Today we will discuss the right of the companion. Regarding this, Imam Sajjad Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam has said, and the right of the companion is that you should act as his companion with nobility as much as you can. Otherwise, you should at least treat him with fairness. Honor him as he honors you and guard him as he guards you, and do not let him precede you in generosity. And if he precedes you, then recompense him. Do not fall short of giving him the love that he deserves. Commit yourself to advise him, care for him, and help him perform the acts of obedience to his Lord, and help him restrain himself from any act of disobedience of his Lord that he might attempt. Then be a mercy upon him and not a chastisement, and there is no power but in Allah the Almighty. From the words of the Imam, peace and blessings be upon him, we can learn that the rights of your companion include treating with nobility as much as possible. At least be fair with him. Another right is to honor him as he honors you. Try to be the first one to treat the other one with kindness. Return his favors. You must also commit yourself to advise him to do acts of obedience to God and always restrain him from sinful acts. Try to be like a blessing for him. Humans are constantly learning from friends. We influence others. Others influence us. Therefore, the Holy Quran warns us about the possibility of deviation and depicts for us a scene in the hereafter when man realizes that ignorant and tricky companions have corrupted him. Then he wishes that he had never made friends with them. However, then it is too late to be sorry. The Holy Quran says, the day that the wrongdoer will bite at his hands, he will say, oh, would that I had taken a straight path with the apostle. Ah, woe is me. Would that I had never taken such a one for a friend. He did lead me astray from the message of Allah after it had come to me. Ah, the evil one is but a traitor to man. The Holy Quran al-Furqan, chapter 25, verses 27 to 29. Man's state of extreme sorrow for following the footsteps of an evil friend is shown in these verses. Although these verses refer to the hereafter, there are many people who greatly suffer from the companionship of bad friends, love their property and honor. Common sense tells us that not to associate ourselves with bad people. But in addition to our common sense, there are many traditions or narrations from the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, and the Ahlul Bayt that confirm this to us. Imam Ali, the commander of the faithful, peace and blessings be upon him, said, avoid the companionship of wicked people, since your nature will unknowingly adopt their wickedness. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam said, whoever associates with bad friends will not remain sound. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam has also said, whoever does not avoid the companionship of a fool will come close to adopting his behavior. These traditions point out that man is influenced by his friends and will adopt their behavior. If his friends are stupid or wicked, then he will unknowingly adopt their behavior and act like them. The fact that the physicians have pointed out about contagious diseases is not limited to physical illness. Some mental illnesses are contagious too. When Imam Ali said, your nature will unknowingly adopt their wickedness, he referred exactly to this fact. In addition, when Imam Sadiq alayhi salam said, whoever associates with bad friends will not remain sound, he referred to this fact too. There is a funny story regarding this topic. A person needed to dig a well in his yard, asked someone to come and dig one for him. A large amount of dirt was dug out of the well and piled up in the yard. He wondered what to do with that dirt. He went to a friend of his and asked for advice. His friend was a fool. He told him to dig another well in the yard and then throw the dirt from the first one in it. He did the same but ended up with a large amount of dirt from the second well piled up on the other side of his yard. He went to his friend again to ask for more advice. His friend told him to simply pour the dirt from the second well he had dug into the first one. It has been narrated on the authority of Solomon, do not express an opinion about a person before you consider with whom he keeps company, since a man is only known through his types of friends and associates he has, and is described in relation to his companions and intimates. Solomon beautifully and eloquently describes that judging a specific individual is based on who they consider their friends. Let's go for a quick break. Stay tuned. Thank you. Welcome back. Imam Ali, peace and blessings be upon him, said, there is no good in the companionship of one in whom six qualities are combined. One, those who lie when they tell you something. Two, those who consider you to be telling a lie when you tell them something. Three, those who betray you after you trust them. Four, those who will accuse you of something after they trust you. Five, those who will not be grateful when you confer a favor on them. Six, those who, if they confer a favor on you, will make mention of it. Imam al-Baqir, peace be upon him, said, my father advised me as follows. O my son, be sure not to associate, converse, or travel with five groups of people. I asked him, O father, may I be your ransom? Who are these five groups of people? He replied, do not associate yourself with corrupt people, since they will sell you for morsel or less than that. I asked him, O father, what is meant by less? He said, they will desire it, but will not get what they wanted. Then I asked, O father, who are the second group? He said, do not associate with misers, since they will deprive you of their property when you need it the most. I asked, who are the third group? He said, do not associate with liars, since they are like a mirage. They will make the near seem distant to you and make the distant seem near. Then I asked, who are the fourth group of people? He replied, do not associate yourself with fools, since they will cause you harm even though they intend to help you. Then I asked, who are the fifth group? He said, do not associate with those who cut off ties with their relatives, since I have found them cursed in three places in the Holy Quran. Now, let us consider the verses that Imam Sajjad referred to. Then, is it to be expected of you, if ye were put in authority, that ye will do mischief in the land and break your ties of kith and kin? Such are the men whom God has cursed, for he has made them deaf and blinded their sight. The Holy Quran, chapter 47, verses 23 and 24. The Holy Quran, chapter 47, verses 22 and 23. These verses are about a group of hypocrites, and for the second occasion, but those who break the covenant of God after having plighted their word thereto, and cut asunder those things which God has commanded to be joined, and work mischief in the land, on them is the curse, for them is the terrible home. The Holy Quran, Ra'ad, chapter 13, verse 25. The ideological and scientific corruption of the materialistic people are summarized in the following three in the above verse. 1. Breaking divine covenants, including natural, intellectual, and religious ones. 2. Cutting off relationships, including ties with God, with divine leaders, and with oneself. 3. Corruption on the earth. In addition, the third verse reads as follows. Those who break God's covenant after it is ratified, and who sunder what God has ordered to be joined, and do mischief on earth, these cause loss only to themselves. The Holy Quran, Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 27. Now let's take a look at who we should associate ourselves with. We can clearly distinguish that through Imam Hassan's advice to Junada, in a part of his advice to Junada ibn Amyat, Imam al-Hassan said, if you feel you need to associate yourself with others, associate with the following people. 1. Associate with people whose association is like an adornment for you. 2. Associate with people who will protect you when you serve them. 3. Associate with people who will help you when you need help. 4. Associate with people who will accept what you tell them as the truth. 5. Associate with people who will strengthen any bonds of friendship that you initiate with them. 6. Associate with people who will accept your favors when you favor them out of nobility. 7. Associate with people who will cover up anything that might harm your honor. 8. Associate with people who will recognize your good deeds towards them. 9. Associate with people who will grant you when you ask, and if you are silent, give you without your asking. 10. Associate with people who will be sympathetic with you when you face hardships. The commander of the faithful, Ali, peace be upon him, said, do not be friends with anyone unless he is pious and intelligent. Only associate with a righteous scholar. Do not entrust your secrets to anyone except believers who honor their promises. He also said, know that associating with the scholar and following him is a practice with which God is served. Obedience to him results in the attainment of good deeds and the elimination of evil deeds. It will be a savings for a believer and an elevation in their position in this life and after death. With this, we conclude this episode. Stay tuned for another episode on the Treaties of Rights. Thank you all for watching, and may Allah hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi, ajjala ta'ala farajahu sharif. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.